Nemesis at Alton Towers is widely considered to be one of the greatest inverts ever built, and I can definitely agree with that. There's a lot of people who say it's the best, and while I'm not sure I would consider it the greatest invert ever made, I can absolutely appreciate how just incredible this ride is from an architectural standpoint. I mean, just look at these stats. The first thing you'll probably notice is that it's a height of 43 feet and a drop of 104 feet. How does it do that? This entire ride is built in trenches. This is like the definition of a terrain coaster. Alton Towers has this thing where they can't build above the tree line, and so they want to pack in a crazy good ride that isn't tall. And so they did that by building the station down into the ground, having the lift hill climb up to the highest it can go, and then the rest of the ride all takes place at ground level or below ground level. It's pretty amazing, actually. So I think that's why a lot of people like this ride so much. And so as a result of that, the ride gets a lot of hype. Before I went in riding it, people were saying, oh, it's the best ride at Alton Towers, or it'll be your favorite ride in the UK. And actually, Nemesis wasn't my favorite ride in the UK, nor was it my favorite ride at Alton Towers. I liked the Smiler more. Because really, the first time I rode Nemesis, I was actually kind of underwhelmed. Like, it was good, but it just didn't meet the hype that I was expecting. However, then I rode it again in the front row. Because with rides like this, you really gotta try different rows to kind of get the full experience. And so I tried the back first, because naturally, that's kind of gonna be where the more intense ride experience is, and that's where I was kind of underwhelmed. But once I rode it in the front, I actually really enjoyed it, and the reason I believe I liked it more in the front was because I could actually see all the trenches we were diving in and out of, all the near misses. The back is definitely more about feeling it, while the front was very visual. And so yeah, obviously the ride is like really intense. Alton Towers is calling it the most intense coaster in the world. I'm not sure I would call it that, but I got off in the back and I was like, yeah, okay, it's definitely like pretty intense and all, but I don't know, it was kind of short, wasn't huge on it. I didn't get like why everyone loved it so much, but then from a front row standpoint, I definitely can understand that. And what's interesting is I thought the same exact thing with Black Mamba. I'll go into that a bit more when I do that review. But it was kind of the same situation where I realized that I liked a lot more the front because you can really appreciate all the terrain interaction and near misses. So bottom line, if you're gonna go ride this, try more than one row. So before we kind of go into the ride experience, I want to talk about the theme. I love the theming for Nemesis. It's essentially this alien that's kind of taken over the area. So the entire station is kind of wrapped in what would look like the inside of some sort of creature. It's kind of skeletal, like organ-like. They even have fake B&M track wrapped around the outside of it that has been like possessed by this creature or taken over. It's like really cool. I didn't know about that going in, and so I saw that and I was like, whoa, like that's actually awesome. So bravo Alton Towers for the theme. I really did enjoy that. Another thing that they've done is really kind of make that area look good with all the trenches and stuff. So you'll see some landscaping. There's a stream that actually runs underneath the coaster, which the water is not red, which for some reason I had the impression going in that the water underneath Nemesis was red. No, it just looks like normal water, but that would have been really cool if it were red. So anyways, theming, great. Delving a bit into your experience, you start up with this lift hill and you bank left, and then you have this drop. Now, the thing about this drop is it is not much of a drop. It's kind of a general slope down. What's incredible to me, I'm not a physics major at all. I'm not sure I get just how all this intensity and speed comes from this tiny little drop. It's not steep by any means. It's a gradual descent down and it flips you into a corkscrew. And then suddenly it's like, positive G-forces. It just slams you all around. So that's what's amazing to me. But anyways, kind of following that first inversion, you're going to bank low to the ground. Pretty much all of this ride is low to the ground. I'm just going to say that now. Your next inversion is a zero G roll over the station to the other side into a trench, banking up, turning around into a vertical loop. You pass back onto the other side of the ride. This is a very steep bank turn following that. Kind of wraps to the far side of the coaster. Now you're back in a trench, flipping into another corkscrew, and then you turn into the brake run. So, not much. You have four inversions, which is good and all. Track length is pretty short, not even 2,500 feet long. But I think a lot of that reasoning probably was just due to land space, or they ran out of trenches to build. I'm not sure, but I would say that Nemesis, it is not my favorite invert. However, it is probably the most unique invert. Even more so than Black Mamba, because Black Mamba at least has some height to it. This does not. So for that reason alone, I would say put this on your bucket list. But as far as theming and like the experience you're gonna get, it's really strong. But when you look at like the layout itself, I wouldn't say it is as good as some of the other B&M inverts that have been built around the world. However, I would put this one as one of the best. Is it overrated? Yeah, I'd say a little, but it's still good. So for its final score, I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10. Main reason why I'm not giving it a perfect score, I'd say really is just because of the length. Kind of the main reason why I think I walked away disappointed after my first ride was because it felt too short. But I think after that front row ride where I could see all the things that we were flying in and out of, I wasn't really disappointed. I didn't really care that it wasn't that long of a ride. But that's going to kind of wrap up this Nemesis review at Alton Towers. Be sure to let me know down in the comment section below if you've ridden this coaster, if you agree with my thoughts. If you disagree, you can let me know down in the comments below. And of course, stay tuned for more coaster reviews here at Coaster Studios, and I'll catch you guys next time.